बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम एंड वेलकम टू अनदर लेक्चर ऑन ह्यूमन फैक्टर्स इंजीनियरिंग। वी वर ऑन मॉड्यूल वन, दैट इज फिजिकल एर्गोनॉमिक्स और बॉडी सेंटर्ड एर्गोनॉमिक्स, एंड आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑक्यूपेशनल बायोमैकेनिक्स। सो दीज आर द रेफरेंसेज आई कंसल्टेड to prepare this lecture. So you might notice a new book, this first one, Basic Biomechanics by S.J. Hall, and rest of the books I have already provided you, or I have mentioned them in the previous lectures. So learning objectives of this lecture are to understand the concept of muscular strength, the factors it depends on. Then we will solve some simple problems related to biomechanics to find forces and torques acting on or generated by human body structures, especially muscles and joints. Then we will solve problems involving manual handling of loads, especially to find the forces and torques acting on or generated by the structures of backbone. And finally, we will discuss some ergonomic implications of the concepts discussed. So there are three types of muscles in humans: the skeletal muscles, they are also called striated muscles, cardiac muscles, and smooth muscles. Muscle action can be classified as being either voluntary or involuntary. That is under the control of the humans or not under the control of humans. The second and third, the cardiac muscles and smooth muscles, contract without conscious thought, so they fall under this second category, and that is why they are termed involuntary. Whereas the skeletal muscles contract upon command. So this first category, the muscles that attach to the bones, they are called skeletal muscle, and they are under voluntary control. So they move bones and the related structures. So the classification of muscles we discussed in module 0 actually applies to skeletal muscles. So our focus is on skeletal muscles. We will discuss the structure of these skeletal muscles in some detail once we discuss the topic of physiology. But you have to keep in mind right now that our focus so far has been on skeletal muscles, and that will continue in the rest of the course as well. The tensile force developed by the muscle pulls on the attached bones and creates torque at the joints crossed by the muscles. So muscle by nature generate tensile force because of their fibrous structure, and that creates torque at the joints that those muscles cross. And then it is possible that one joint is crossed by more than one muscle, or one muscle crosses more than one joint. The magnitude of the torque generated is the product of the muscle force and moment arm. So you are aware of that, that torque is force into moment arm. The net torque present at a joint determines the direction of any resulting movement. Net torque. So what is the net torque? The net torque at a joint is the vector sum of the muscle torque and the resistive torque. So we will see that according to Newton's third law, when there is a force acting on some point, say joint, in this case there will be a resistive force as well. So that force will have its torque as well. So there are different factors that generate torque. So one of them is the weight of the body segment itself. So weight is a force, so that generates a torque. External forces acting on the body, they also generate a torque. and tension in any muscle crossing the joint, that also generates torque. So these torques plus any resistive torque, actually their net torque determines the direction in which a muscle and eventually a body part moves. You are aware that when a force is acting at some angle, it can be resolved into two components. So for example, if this force is acting at this specific point, making an angle alpha, so it can be converted into two components. So for example, this component will be the perpendicular component, and this component will be the horizontal component of this force. So resolving a muscle force into two orthogonal or perpendicular components, they are perpendicular to each other. So one is this vertical component, and other is horizontal component. So they actually both produce torque. So the component of muscle force acting parallel to the attached bone does not produce the torque, since it is directed through the joint center and therefore has a moment arm of zero. So F into D, if D is zero, the torque will be zero. And the component of muscular force that produces torque at the joint crossed is directed perpendicular to the attached bone. So you can see in the figure as well that in this case, if you are interested to find the torque, for example, at this point, then the torque because of this horizontal component will be zero because of the zero moment arm. But this perpendicular component has certain moment arm. So the torque generated will be because of this perpendicular. So again, the force into moment arm is the torque. Another question is the direction of the torque, whether it is a clockwise torque or counterclockwise. So it depends upon two factors. One is the point about which we are interested to find the torque. And second is the direction of the force. So for example, if you are interested to find a torque about this point, and that is the torque that is generated because of this force, Fm in this case. So the torque will be counterclockwise. Considering these two points collectively, the direction of the force, that is upward, and the point about which we are going to find the torque. So the tendency of this force to create torque will be to create counterclockwise torque. Now, for example, if we are interested to find torque at this point, so if you call it point A and we call it point B, so in this case, the torque will be clockwise because this force has a tendency to move this point B in a clockwise direction. The direction of the force and the point about which we intend to find the value of torque determine the direction of torque. Now, torque mathematically depends upon the moment arm or the perpendicular distance of the force from the point about which the torque is to be found. But there are other factors as well. So one of them is the strength of the muscle. So the greater is the strength of the muscle, the greater will be the torque. We have discussed the second point, the lever arm or the moment arm. And the third is the pole angle. So we have discussed it as well. So the greatest torque will be produced by force that is acting at right angle to the point. And it will keep on decreasing as you move towards the point about which we are interested to find the torque, and it will be zero if that force passes through the point, or the angle of that force at that point becomes zero. So these are the three factors on which the torque depends. And another question is on which factor does the strength of the muscle depend? Strength of the muscle. So strength of the muscle depends upon the thickness of the fibers. So we know that the muscles consist of different fibers. So the thicker the fibers of a specific muscle are, the greater will be the length of the muscle and greater will be the torque. The second factor is the number of fibers. So number of fibers actually determine the size of muscle. So greater is the size of muscle, that is the more the number of fibers are there, the greater will be the strength of that muscle and greater will be the torque. And the third factor is strength of fibers. The stronger the fibers are in a muscle, of course, the greater will be the strength of that muscle and greater will be the torque producing capability of that muscle. So the second point, actually, the number of fibers determine the size of the muscle. So that is why it is recommended that when lifting heavy loads, the larger muscles should be used. For example, thigh muscles can be used to bring that load upward, say to waist height or above, and then use, for example, your arm and hands to carry that load. The strength training or the exercise increases the thickness of fibers, first point, but probably not the number of fibers. Because the size of muscle also depends upon genetic factors, but in general, by exercise, we can increase the strength of muscles. In the next segment, we will solve some mathematical problems related to biomechanics, and especially focusing on the muscles and joints. Thank you.